and today I am going to finalize this topic, oogenesis. Children, till yet we have discussed that how this process continues inside the female ovary within the reproductive system. Children, this whole process starts before the birth among the girls, when they are in form of fetus inside the mother's womb. And this whole process continues till the menopause. Children, before we have discussed the diagrammatic explanation, and today I'll be explaining with the flow diagram on the board. And this is one of the most important diagram according to the NCERT book, and it is very important for the board point of view also. So today I am going to discuss the diagram related to NCERT. Now children, here the whole process is completed by the two types of cell division, mitosis and meiosis. Mitosis is an equational division where your number of chromosomes are maintained, they are retained. Hence, it is called as equational division, where the 2n number of chromosomes are maintained. The second type of cell division is meiosis, which is also called as reductional division, where the number of chromosomes reduces to half. It becomes n number of chromosomes. This whole oogenesis process, which starts before the birth of girls and it remains till the menopause, during this whole life cycle of the oogenesis, two types of cell division occurs, which is completed by the two phases, that is your mitosis and meiosis. So children, let us begin with the process. Now you can see that on the board I have divided the section into two parts. Within this green box, above it I have written before birth. So it means that these are the phases which will be occurring before the birth, which will be taking place before the birth. That means this is a process which is taking place inside the mother's womb when the girl child is in form of fetus. Now children, this middle part is the childhood stage where your ovary remains inactive. It means that the process of oogenesis is paused at the prophase first stage. Now children, below this green box I have written from puberty to menopause. So these are the stages which are occurring, which are starting from the puberty, and it ends up at the menopause. These are those stages. These are before and these are after, and in between your childhood stages going on. So let us now begin. Now children, the oogenesis begins with the process of formation of oogonium cells. And these oogoniums are developed from the germinal epithelium lining, which is present inside the ovary of the female reproductive system. Now children, oogonium is a diploid structure, hence it undergoes mitosis division and equational division. Then again this oogonium undergoes mitosis division to form a primary oocyte, and this is also a diploid structure which is your following mitosis. And children, before birth, as we have discussed this a lot, that your primary oocyte is arrested in a prophase first before birth. After birth, neither a cell is added or they are formed inside, newly cells are formed, or not from anywhere they are added. This line is very important, which is mentioned in the NCERT book. Now, so this primary oocyte is arrested in the prophase first stage inside the ovary of the fetus, and then the time comes of the childbirth, of the girl childbirth. Now the child takes birth and she enters into the childhood period, and till reaching to the puberty, that means till the girl reaches to the age of 12 to 13, till then your ovary remains inactive. It means that this primary oocyte which is formed there, it remains inactive. Neither it is finishing its meiosis and neither it is developing more. Now what happens, children? They are arrested in this condition during the childhood period. Now this primary oocyte, after the girls attain puberty, this primary oocyte, a diploid structure which has been arrested in the meiosis first, prophase first region stage, now it enters again into the meiosis first to complete the all the stages of prophase first, like your zygotene, pachytene, diplotene and diakinesis, and rest of the phases like your anaphase first, metaphase first, telophase first. So all these stages this primary oocyte, it finishes, and this primary oocyte, which is a diploid structure, after completing its meiosis first stage, it's divided into two irregular cells where it one of is bigger in size and the other one is smaller in size, and these cells are haploid structures. Now the meiosis first has completed and the number of chromosomes have reduced to half. That is why the cells produced after its division, here what is happening, the number of chromosomes is half. So cells are haploid in number. Now sir, children, here the two irregular cells which are formed, among them one which is formed is the first polar body and the second which is formed is the secondary oocyte. Polar body is also haploid and secondary oocyte is also haploid. Till yet there is no function known of polar body, and slowly this first polar body diminishes, it is destroyed inside the body. There is no function till yet known that why the first polar body is meant, but the second body, the second cell, the secondary oocyte is there. Now children, this secondary oocyte enters into the meiosis second, and this meiosis second completed, this meiosis second is completed only if the secondary oocyte gets fertilized with the sperm. If it is getting fertilized with the sperm. The secondary oocyte, children, will complete the meiosis second only and only if the sperm is fertilizing this secondary oocyte, and then only the zygote formation will take place, and this zygote will again will be changing into a diploid structure, which is your 2N structure. Hope children, this is understood to you all, that the oogonium, which is a diploid structure, is formed by mitosis division to increase in number. Now when this oogonium changes into primary oocyte, is again a diploid structure, and before birth this is arrested in the prophase first leptotene stage. Now the child takes birth, completes its childhood, and then she attains puberty, and the girl attains the first menstrual cycle. During that menstrual cycle, this primary oocyte enters back again to the meiosis first. Now this meiosis first is completed and the structure enters into secondary oocyte. Now it enters into meiosis second. Now during the meiosis second, secondary oocyte is getting fertilized with the sperm and zygote is formed, and this zygote is a diploid structure. Now children, on my left side you can see I have mentioned here the structure related to follicles. In the last video I have discussed the development and the growth of follicles in detail. That how primary follicles are formed from the oogonium and how it is developing into the graafian follicle. Now children, this oogonium cell in the initial state I told you all is also called as primordial follicle. Now this primordial follicle, it is remaining before the birth. But after attaining puberty, this primordial follicle, around it granulosa cells engulfs and they change into primary follicle. Now this primary follicle will grow and develop, and it will be developing into secondary and your tertiary follicle. So in the growing follicle, this is a growing follicle where your secondary layer is developing and the tertiary layer is developing, and this gapping, this space is antrum. Now slowly, slowly children, this primary follicle will change into mature follicle, and this mature follicle is called as graafian follicle. And this graafian follicle, when it is developed, fully matured, now the structure which is holding, that is secondary oocyte. Now children, you might be thinking that which are the structures which are primary part, which are the primary structure. Primordial follicle is a primary, these are your primary structure. Primary follicle is a primary structure. Growing follicle is even a primary structure. But graafian follicle is entering into the meiosis second, and they will be changing into secondary oocyte. So children, during the ovulation process, when the ovum is released out from the graafian follicle, during that process, ovulation, this structure changes into secondary oocyte. Now children, this graafian follicle, after the ovum released, this graafian follicle will change into blood-filled pouch-like structure called as corpus luteum, and it will be forming, developing your progesterone hormone which is required throughout the pregnancy period if your fertilization takes place. But if your fertilization is not taking place, then this corpus luteum will change into corpus albunicus, which will be discarded in form of white scar like tissue like structure. Now children, this secondary oocyte, now the most important thing to tell is that when this ovum is getting ovulated, when the process of ovulation is taking place and the ovum is released inside the fallopian tube. Now children, what is that structure? Is that structure a complete mature ovum? No. Inside this fallopian tube, the structure which is released, the ovum which is released, that is still not completed the meiosis second. That is in the stage of secondary oocyte. Always children remember that after ovulation, the part of ovum which is released into the fallopian tube, that is your secondary oocyte. This secondary oocyte will convert into mature complete egg ovum when? Only when the sperm is going to fertilize. When the sperm will fertilize the secondary oocyte, then the secondary oocyte will be completing the rest of the process of meiosis second. And after completing rest stages of the meiosis second, now the structure will be changing into mature zygote, and the zygote will be developed. And this zygote will change into embryo, and embryo will change into fetus. So children, hope you have understood this whole process of oogenesis, and I have tried my best to explain each and every point, each and every section, that how the ovary is working in the development of the mature ovum, which process is starting before the birth and is ending till the menopause. It's a long duration period through which the journey of the ovum is passing through. I hope, children, it is very much clear to you all. Thank you.